Salut à tous, my name is Marion Buricatu. I am a French artist and I lived here in the United States since 2001. This video is about art and how to impress your friends and family at the museum with three easy facts.
Why are the paintings by Jackson Pollock so interesting? Well, merci for asking, and the answer is very simple. Jackson Pollock was a bad boy, hard-fighting cowboy. He was a tragic hero. So here is a painting called Number 31 by Jackson Pollock. It was painted in 1930, and this painting is at the Museum of Modern Art in New York City. Fact number one, the tragic public figure of the abstract expressionist movement. So Jackson Pollock was born in 1912 in the Midwest, and he died in 1956 at the age of 44, which was pretty young, in an alcohol-related car accident. There was two sides to his personality, and one good side and one tragic side. The good side is that he was a very instinctive painter. He was very, he was very spontaneous in the way he was painting. He was even quoted as saying, "I am one with nature when I paint." That just shows how he was just natural in the way he was painting. The problem was his tragic side. He was a very depressive person, and he also suffered from alcoholism. Because of that, the fame crushed him, and in his latest year of his life, he was recycling old ideas. I do find it interesting because I do believe that there's something tragic about all the artists of the abstract expressionist movement, and I feel that he is a perfect public figure for this movement. Okay, now, fact number two. Jack the Dripper. That was his nickname. Yes, Jack the Dripper. So here is a painting called Autumn Rhythm. And this is really his signature style. It is called the dripping method. So what was the dripping method? What happened is that he would paint on large, unstretched canvas on the floor. He would use a can of paint. He would use a brush or just a wood stick. He would dip it in his in the can of paint, and then he would, you know, put the paint he would drip the paints. You see, in a beautiful movement on the canvas. Okay, but for that, he would also use another technique. And this other technique is called the action painting, or also the gestural painting. And it was like a dance. So what was he doing? What was he doing is that what he did is that he would walk around his canvas on the floor. And as he was walking around, he would take the paint from the can and he would drip it, and he would make big movement. And the bigger the movement, the bigger the drips are on the canvas. Honestly, it's absolutely beautiful. And it's fascinating to imagine him dancing around his painting. There is something I have to say, and you can see that on the painting of me trying to do this same exercise, is that I strongly suggest you to next summer, when the weather is nice, in your yard, just buy a big unstretched piece of canvas at any art store and buy, like, you know, three small cans of fur paint, red, black and green, anything, and use some wood stick. Do that with your family, do that with your children, and just drip the paint. Move around and do it, and you will see, when you go and see his paintings, you will appreciate them much more because you will have done it by yourself. It's a wonderful and liberating experience. Now, fact number three, enamel paint. Something I usually say in art history is that when there is an avant-garde art movement, it is usually connected to a technical innovation. What was the technical innovation at that time? Enamel paint by the car industry. So the ABEX, the abstract expressionist, they used to say, well, if it is good enough for Ford Motor Company, it's good enough for me. The enamel paint had some nice quality because it was fluid, it is fluid, it is opaque, and it is rich in pigment, and it makes really some nice drippings on the canvas. And you know, it's not that easy. Well, so let me now remind you of the three facts easy to remember about Jackson Pollock. First, the tragic hero, the public figure of the abstract expressionist movement. Second, it's about Jack the Dripper. And third, the enamel paint. Okay, so now, if you want to impress your friends and family even more, or just have fun, the next video is just for you because I have created 7 trivia questions about Jack the Dripper. Bye bye.
Nice chatting with you. Abonne-toi, which means subscribe to my channel. Have fun and see you at the next video.